Hi loves, welcome back to my channel. For those who don't know me, I go by name of Unfiltered Giddy, and if you're new here, definitely subscribe to this Unfiltered Fam honey. So loves, on today's video we're actually going to feature Okay Yams. Guys, I saw something on Twitter and it's a question. People were asking questions, do we really think the money that Okay Yams has, it's literally legit? It's a clean money. Guys, let me tell you something. Okay Yams has blocked me for the longest time, guys. When a Twitter, when a Instagram, when a King TikTok, everywhere. Beside here, YouTube, I am able to see her vlogs, obviously. But when it comes to Instagram, Twitter, and stuff like that, Baby Girl has, you know, removed me from her page because of the video that I did about her, and she didn't like it and stuff like that. I could say that we are beefing somewhere somehow, even though she doesn't know me. Okay, so I saw some comment on King Go Twitter. People were asking, okay, I'm so nemali, ne? She's rich, ne? But is her money so legit, guys? Imali, I can eat clean. I see him, guys. Nyanazi, you're gonna attack me and stuff like that. No. I just saw that comment. I'm like, okay, what? Like, you put it okay. What makes you even think Kuguti Malia Kaiko clean? Then that's when I remembered Kuguti. Okay, remember she used to date this Nigerian guy, and clearly this Nigerian guy has friends, right? And that doesn't mean Kuguti. When she broke up with the guy that she was dating, the friends that like she made in that relationship and all that stuff, that close. Maybe they're not close, but they're still friends. So I would like to believe that the reason why they even ask that kind of question is because Baby Girl is hanging around Nigerian guys and stuff like that, and we know that Nigerian men, like, they are known for, you know, doing some shady stuff. Like, we know, guys. No, it's not something that you should question. Hence why, like, when I saw that comment and saw people like commenting, Guti, Abu Mishali have been in this good game for the longest time, but they don't buy the house and stuff like that. Yes, Baby Girl is making money, she's working and stuff like that, but Imalengaga, for her to buy a house and a new car, and like, the question was, how could she even afford a house go Cape Town? Guys, if you know the story about Cape Town and the way Uturanga corner, guys, then Luena, you would ask this question. But now, guys, I'm not really questioning Uturanga. One thing for sure is that Baby Girl is working hard. Let me just be honest with you. Baby Girl is working so hard, and we see her effort. We do see Uzamagwake, guys. So maybe, like, she's responsible when it comes to how she spent her money. Unlike Abu Mishali, they always want to travel and buy it in tow, bafa banana, the chalet and stuff like that. you know, guys, like Leroy, she even attacked Leroy, go to Tatimali and stuff like that. I'm a responsibility to this, guys, our fan. You'll never know who to Mishali wins that. So we can't be out here comparing Abu Mishali and Abu Kiyams. Oh, Baby Girl, obviously, so why should we question the mere fact that she can afford a house, a new car, and stuff like that? We do see her hard work. We literally do see how her hard work, despite Uguti, she's friends with Nigerian men and stuff like that. That doesn't mean Uguti, like, they are cleaning their money with UKMC because of people who are not, you know, Sola eating mobile veil already. She's a hard working woman and she's like receiving a lot of money for her hard work and stuff like that. Now, as I said, guys, I don't actually question Uguti Imali ake eating or not. I believe Uguti Baby Girl, like, the way I think, guys, the way she's so determined and she's so focused and stuff like that, I believe really she's that person who can afford a house because of her classic eating. So guys, we see these influencers, these celebrities, guys, like Maguya Lena, Bobaya, guys, but Okay Yams, she's still Okay Yams. Hence why a lot of people do enjoy her content here on YouTube. Abantu, she's so natural in terms of the way she does her like content. Yes, Lennon, like she was trying to fall in that whole category of Uzi, I'm a slay queens, but unfortunately, Asibuyena. And Lena, I think she has accepted it. I'm not a baddie. I'm just okay. And people love me the way Kilenka Tengi. I don't have to change anything. I don't have to get BBL. I don't have to do those fillers and stuff like that. Even though people are coming out, like, are coming for her looks because she's not pretty and what. I get Luna Selena Lee, a beauty standard salon, I sell Luna surprising. So why would you compare Abu Kayams with those people? If she's not pretty to you, then it's fine. But okay, I'm just like she looks natural, guys. Even though she wears makeup and stuff like that, but you would not tell because of how beautiful she is. She's not those ladies who would go to take it, but fix me lo mwabo or never fix her in. No, she's a natural beauty, and I do like it for her. And as I said, guys, mean I really like the people that I'm talking about. When I'm saying bad things and stuff like that doesn't mean Ukuthi ngiyabazonda, guys. It's just that I'm pointing out what I see and stuff like that. So when if you don't like it, khotswa go wena. So yeah, guys, that's what I actually wanted to say. It's so funny that people are out here questioning Ukuthi abolona ba imali yabo iclean na ngoba just because of oh baby girl is living her life. Ngemali yakhe, guys. So funny. But anyway, guys, that's my two cent opinion regarding this whole situation. When I saw that tweet and people were commenting about Umisal, I'm like, is when are we going to stop about this whole situation of comparing Ogutuban wins and wins and Amalona with our funny guys? The responsibility that one guys had it one, like we can't compare. Like, let's stop that. It's all about like we always comparing Umisali, Miss XO, what? No. Baby girl is on her journey. And I'm so glad that she didn't get influenced by this slay queen wannabes and stuff like that. Oh, what? No. Look at her. Her hard work is showing out. But yes, she can afford a house for Cape Town. She can afford to buy a brand new house. A brand new car, I mean. Because of how hard she works. But anyway, as I said, guys, that's my two cent opinion regarding this whole situation. And do feel free to share yours on the comment section down below. And subscribe if you're actually new here. I love you guys. Bye.